Hey people. Okay, so today I'm going to discuss the four new champions that have been crowned at TNA Genesis. Obviously I'm making this a good 5 days after Genesis aired, but I figure might as well make something about TNA that isn't just a review. Might as well make a thoughts video on new champions. So let's get started with that. First, we have the new X Division champion, which is Kazarian. They have done crap with the X Division championship lately. I think the X Division title is supposed to be prestigious. It's supposed to be worth something. It's supposed to be good. It's one of the original TNA titles and something that should be held in way higher of a regard than it is. It's basically just a piece of crap now. And the last 6, 8, 10 title reigns have been shit. Jay Lethal's had it 3-4 times. Each reign's been like 10 days long. Robbie E, that New Jersey Shore lookalike fucker, had it for a month. And it's like each title reign's a month long. Nobody's defending it very often. The rivalries have been shit with it. It's just been bad. And they've been doing a flat out bad job with the X Division Championship. It's really disappointing. That was one of their big titles and they never should have. It's supposed to be that championship that's exclusive to TNA. You know, it's that TNA, like, only TNA has that X Division Championship. And it should have been way. It used to be so. They used to have such good matches involved with the X Division title. You used to get world title 5-star great matches for the X Division title, and now you're getting crap for it. Now that Kazarian's champ, does that do shit for anything? Not really. I mean, I like Kazarian. He's a very good in-ring wrestler, good heel. We get to find that out. He's a good heel. I think he's cool, but do I think he makes a good X Division champ? I don't think anybody makes a good X Division champ right now. They really need to rebuild what this belt is supposed to be worth and make it prestigious again. Then we can have some good X Division champions. Get Kazarian to defend it against some great opponents. Amazing Red is a great X Division competitor. That's why I wouldn't even mind if one of the Generation Me, those guys, Motor City Machine Guns, each of them on their own, Chris Sabin, Alex Shelley, Max Buck, Jeremy Buck, whoever, if they go for the X Division title, even if it's a singles title, at least other good possible X Division competitors can go for it. They really don't have a huge X Division anymore that they used to have. All those guys like Daniels and, I mean, Samoa Joe and Styles are too big now for that stuff. So, but they shouldn't ever be too big. They should be able to get an X Division title whenever, or go for the title whenever. You know, it should be prestigious. It's supposed to be the second highest championship, and I think it's fallen down about third or fourth. I'd put it under the tag titles and then put the television title second most important now to the world title. It's really too bad because the X Division Championship is supposed to be huge and it's TNA's big draw for a title and it hasn't been doing much of anything lately. And with this new reign, it's really not doesn't really matter. But anyway, the next champ is Beer Money winning the tag titles from Motor City Machine Guns. I like Beer Money a lot. I like Machine Guns are my favorite tag team, but TNA has a great tag team division. I'm sure there will be some great title defenses that Beer Money will have against Machine Guns. They already did have a good one this past Thursday. It was a pretty good match. It was short, but it was a good match. Probably have some against Generation Me, Inc., all these other tag teams, and whoever. They'll probably have some good tag title defenses and some good matches. So, with the tag team championships, I'm not really concerned. As long as a good, not a joke tag team like Orlando Jordan and Eric Young, as long as a good tag team holds those titles, I'm fine with it. And Beer Money's a great tag team. Great tag team. So, I mean, even the Hardy Boys might be reforming. So, they have plenty of tag teams in TNA for these guys to defend against. But they're all part of Immortal, so you can't really defend against the Hardys. But, say, Inc. picks up the titles, or if the Machine Guns regain them or something, you know, you could have the Hardy Boys go for them instead or something. But anyway, it's cool. The tag titles, I'm not worried about. I'm glad that Beer Money won. I'm not, like, I love the Machine Guns, but I'm not that disappointed. I'm just happy that we have good new champions. Next, Abyss has captured the television title. Now, I'm not very happy about this. I'm going to make it quick, but I'm not very happy that Abyss has won this freaking title. Why the hell did they put the belt on Abyss? They haven't really moved this championship in the right direction from the start. I mean, Booker T takes it out. This is my new title, inaugural champ, whatever. Styles wins it. Kevin Nash had it twice. Mick Foley had it once. Eric Young had it once. I mean, that's back when Eric Young was taken seriously. I liked when Eric Young was taken seriously. That's when I was a pretty big fan of Eric Young. Actually, I probably would have put Eric Young in my top 10 wrestlers for TNA at that time. I really was getting to like Eric Young quite a bit when he was champ. But they made him a joke champ. And Eric Young, they try to make too much of a jokester out of him, when in reality, he actually could be a pretty good in-ring wrestler if they just let him be. But they make his gimmick all stupid and shit, so it sucks. And then who else had it? Rob Terry had it. He's not a good wrestler. He's just a bodybuilder. He really isn't good. And then Styles. Styles has been the best champion, no doubt. And Booker T was a good champion, too. Him and Styles were the best champions, and Booker T ain't even around anymore. And Styles lost it to Williams. That's another good champion. Williams is a good champion. But Styles got legitimately injured a couple weeks back. So he puts Abyss in this match to freaking replace him. So Abyss faces Douglas Williams and ends up beating him because of Styles' interference. And now Abyss is the champion. This doesn't make any sense. I mean, we had some good champions. The title was never really moving in a good direction, except the very beginning and then now. And then they put it in the wrong direction. Abyss. Abyss shouldn't be winning any championships ever again. He's just not that type of championship wrestler. He's supposed to just be a monster that goes and destroys stuff and leaves. He's not supposed to be a champion. You can't take him seriously. That's why he lost to Matt Morgan this week. If he's going to be just a joke champion that loses every match, I don't want him to be the television champion. That's supposed to be, yet again, another prestigious title that's already losing prestige, and it's only been around for 2 years. So they really need to work on the TV and X Division championships, especially. Tag team titles are doing a fine job with. Women's championship, meh. Knockout tag team titles, hell no. And the world title, they're doing fine with. So they're only doing good with about 2 out of the 6 championships in TNA. But anyway, so Abyss, your new TV champion, not really all that happy about it. And finally, Mr. Anderson is your new TNA World Heavyweight Champion. Now, I am very happy about that. Reason is, Mr. Anderson, hell, I love that guy. You know, he is the definition of what a great American wrestler is today. He's got great mic skills, one of the best mic skills there is in all of wrestling. Probably right now I'd have to put him in the top 2. Maybe he might even be the best on the mic right now there is. He made a great speech, a great promo this past last night on Impact. The guy is freaking insane. I just hope he gets the old world title back, because that ugly ass one better be gone. I hate that fucking title. It's so ugly. But it looks really wrong around Anderson too. Like, when it was on Hardy, it looked okay, because you knew it was associated with Hardy. But like, when they put it on Anderson, it looks really stupid. Anderson deserves a real world championship belt. He deserved to win those titles back in WWE, but I'm glad that he made it to the top of TNA. TNA is doing the correct thing with the world championship. Jeff Hardy's reign sucked, though. I have to be honest. Rob Van Dam's reign was really cool. I really enjoyed it. And then we had Hardy's, which sucked. Styles was good. Angles have all been good. Just about every world championship reign they've ever had has been great. And then this one with fucking Hardy sucked. And the reason his reign sucked was because he barely even wrestled. It doesn't matter if it's non-title matches. He didn't wrestle. On Impact, he barely even made appearances, so they pushed him to the top, but in a way, they pushed him to the top and back a little bit. They kind of didn't really bring him out to the spotlight as the world champion. He didn't feel like a world champ. Anderson feels like a world champ already, and I know he's going to defend that title a lot more. He's going to appear every week and have a match every week, and so what can I say? I'm so glad that Mr. Anderson won the TNA Championship. I'm very glad that he finally gets what he deserves and wins the world title. I do think Matt Morgan deserves to win the world title at some point in 2011 or 12. I do think Matt Morgan deserves it. Not necessarily next, but I think he does deserve to win that title at some point, because he is seriously deserving of it at least one time. But Hardy's reign got cut a little bit short and shit, so it sucks. Sucks for him. But anyway, that's all I got for this. Let me know what you think of these new champions in TNA. A shitload of them all at once. But anyway, yep, let me know what you think.